Coming in Angular 20, dynamic components introduce new APIs for bindings, two-way bindings, and directives. First, let's remember how to create a dynamic component. Open the component template and add the host container for the dynamic component. We use an online chat component as an example. This parent component is a user account. The chat component is dynamically created in the account component. This uchild function returns the container reference using a template reference variable. And this reference is stored as a signal in the chat container property. What does the container reference mean? This option tells Angular to return a special container wrapper providing create component. Now let's add a button to open the chat on click. We use this reference to call create component to dynamically create the chat component. The first argument is the component class name. The second argument is an option subject. Angular 20 introduces two new options, bindings and directives. The bindings option supports inputs, outputs, and two-way bindings. All functions must be imported to be used. For example, we want to pass the account balance to this chat. From parent to child. The inputBinding function takes two arguments, the input property name in the child component and the value from the parent component. This value can be signal holding a value or a plain function returning one. Next, let's move on to output bindings. The output binding function also takes two arguments. The output property name in the child component. And a function. This function is executed every time the child output property emits a new value and takes this value as a parameter. This is the type of the emitted value. Let's add buttons to the chat template to emit values. Let's see how it looks in the browser. In this example, the chat passes the status of support access permission. Next, let's move on to two-way bindings. The two-way binding function also takes two arguments: the model property name in the child component. And a writable signal in the parent component. Now the two signals are connected. Any change to one automatically updates the second. We must use a signal for two-way bindings. Next, let's move on to the directives option. This option is an array of directives. A directive can have its own bindings. In this case, instead of just a directive name, we use an object. The directive name is specified in a special property of this object. and we specify bindings in the same way. We must use a signal for two-way bindings.